With the motorbikes, you transport everything on that thing. Like, we go to Pick and Pay and you buy your groceries and you just leave it in your car. Yeah, you go to the market and you put it on your bike. Like, you strap it on your bike and you have to, yeah, it was difficult. But you get used to it. I had a little doggy with me, and it was like the only thing. I went alone, and there was a, my career mission family was there, but I lived alone in my little house in the middle of the jungle. So I decided I should really buy myself like a dog or something. And it didn't last very long because an accident happened and someone drove over the dog. So I decided, okay, maybe I should get something less official and like just adopt a chicken. And so there was this little chicken. I named it Lucky. It wasn't so lucky because I opened my door every evening. I would come home after I taught English. I would come home and Lucky would be waiting outside to go into my house, and he would like pick up all the scorpions and the spiders. So I was really thankful for Lucky because he was actually doing me a huge favor. And then the one evening I was waiting for Lucky, and Lucky didn't show up. So I was like, I went to my neighbor and I'm like, did you maybe see my chicken? And they were having chicken that supper. I have never asked again, and I've decided pets is not a good idea in Cambodia. But through all of this, God gave me this promise. He says, though I walk through the valley of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. And this kept me going. It inspired me, and soon the people in Cambodia became my family. I spent a lot of time with them. They taught me how to read. I taught them how to love God. We had a lot of memorable moments together, and it gave me hope. So I also, last year when I was standing in front of you guys, I told you that I would be a rice worker and I would help plant rice and work with them in the fields. And then my mission family, the career mission family I work with, the husband got cancer, and they had to rush back to America. And so we had this Adventist school. It was open for a year, and no one else could take over the school. So the principal job was given to me, and I had to be the principal of a foreign school in a foreign country with a foreign language. And sometimes you feel like, why me, Lord? These faces gave me hope. It gave me something to work for. And English teaching, I also taught English and music. And it was fun. It was fun. I have a little video clip here to show you just like some of the stuff that made my day.
Dara, niye hippopotamus. Niye.
Niye hippopotamus.
Okay.
Hippopotamus.
Five.
Hippopotamus. Hippopotamus.
Okay.
Hippopotamus.
Funny.
Yeah.
English was fun, and it was a huge blessing. Unfortunately, we had some classroom troubles, especially with the foreign language. It was hard to discipline the children. What do you say if you can't say anything? Like, it was a lot of you, or sit down, or they don't understand. And it was hard, and it motivated me to speak that, to learn the language even faster. Respect. Because you can't discipline them, there was not a lot of respect. And the last one is hygiene. It's the type where you sneeze and then we say, here you go, here's a tissue, and they sneeze and then they just wipe it, and then they play with their friend and they come touch you, and it was awful. But you do get used to it, and you learn to go to the bathroom quite often. It was hard. This is actually a photo one of the kids took of me while I was busy doing my lesson plans, just to give you an idea that it's not always fun and games. But it's like these little faces, like Bisat and Songhai, that gave me hope to carry forward. And it's worth it. It was worth it at the end. It says here, with almost impatient eagerness, the angels wait for our cooperation. For man must be the channel to communicate with man. And when we give ourselves to Christ in wholehearted devotion, angels rejoice that they may speak through our voices to reveal God's love. And I wanted to make sure that I was the channel. I wanted to make sure that I could be used to reach other people. All the discomfort and all out of my comfort zone the whole time, I thought, when am I going to see the fruit? When am I going to see, like, reap the harvest and go back to South Africa and tell, like, many amazing mission stories like all the other missionaries? And finally, it did show off. 10 of our people, they got baptized, And it wasn't, it was Kamai and Bunong. And I won't say, like, because of me, all of these people are standing there today. No, maybe I was a friend to one of them or two of them. I think I know five of them. And it was all around Cambodia. These people got together and they got baptized last year, December. I'm able to say that I was a channel, and God used me. And we are still serving that same God today. We're serving the same God as Moses, Daniel, Elijah, Noah, and David. Still the same God. God expects personal service from everyone to whom he has entrusted a knowledge of the truth for this time. We have that knowledge. We have that truth. Not all can go as missionaries to foreign lands, but all can be home missionaries in their families and neighborhoods. This is us. It's us here. Yes, I'm back in South Africa, but I'm determined to never stop, to go out wherever I find myself. And I challenge you here this morning to get uncomfortable. So this is my challenge I give to you, Pinetown Church. You made it possible for me to go to Cambodia. You made it possible. You supported me, and you made it possible for many Khmer children and Bunong children to hear the truth. And therefore, I challenge you, we have a job. Get uncomfortable. Get out of your comfort zone. Be an open channel for the angels to work through you so we can reach the lost. I have a little video here I'd like to show you guys.
I will run, I will run this race, and I will do it all for love. Your love compels me forward, your love controls my heart, and I just can't, I cannot get. So I will fight this good fight of faith, and I will do it all for love. You are my great reward, you're so worth fighting for, and I can't wait to see your face. I will run, I will run this race, and I will do it all for love. Your love compels me forward, your love controls my heart, and I just can't, I cannot get away. So I good fight of faith, and I will do it all for love. You are my great reward, you're so worth fighting for, and I can't wait to see your face. I can't wait. See?
into one video. I don't know. That was just to give you an idea what actually is going on in Cambodia. And this morning, I know sometimes we look at missionaries and people that went overseas and we think, like, what am I doing for the Lord? And therefore, I know that all of us are not able to go overseas, but all of us are able to be missionaries wherever you find yourself. And therefore, I want to challenge you this morning. Let's close our eyes in prayer. Dear Lord, thank you so much for giving us this privilege to go out and make disciples. Lord, you've given us this job. You could have sent angels, or you could have done it yourself, Lord, but instead you chose us. Thank you, Lord, for this great opportunity. Help us to use it. Help us to use this time here on earth so we can go home soon. We love you so much, Lord, and we hope to see you soon. I pray this in your holy and beloved name. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you. That was inspiring. We will now separate for our lesson study. And if there's a visitor next to you, please take them with you to your class. And we have a youth class in the boardroom.